next on NCBA's Cattleman to Cattleman.
On this week's special edition of NCBA's Cattleman to Cattleman, we take a look at how DNA technology can and will play a vital role in the future of your herd.
And now, NCBA's Cattleman to Cattleman with host Kevin Ochsner.
Hello and welcome to this week's edition of NCBA's Cattleman to Cattleman. I'm Kevin Ochsner. Thanks for joining us. This week, we're taking a look at some of our favorite stories brought to us by Igenity. If you've ever looked at a group of cattle and wondered whether to keep them or sell them, you may have wished for more information to help you decide. In fact, in today's economy, many producers now feel they can't afford to make those decisions without a comprehensive DNA profile. Fortunately, as Brian Baxter reports, that good, hard scientific data is readily available to producers.
Igenity is the most comprehensive, most powerful DNA profile available to beef producers. We give them information on their animals that they can make better decisions whether it comes to breeding, selection, procurement, management, as well as marketing. Producers can realize how they can take advantage of this neat science and put it to work in their operations.
More producers are putting DNA technology to work in their operations. For example, Wayne Cockrell manages the Carter Ranch in Leon County, Texas. Founded in the 1870s, the ranch today is a commercial Brangus cow-calf and stocker operation. Cockrell sees the Igenity profile as a tool to make more informed decisions that will clearly improve his herd.
In any cow herd in any part of the country, we all have that bottom 25% of the cows that are a drain, an economic drain on the rest of the cows. If we can eliminate those cattle, the returns that we will realize out of that may be the difference between staying in this business and not staying in this business.
The Igenity profile evaluates 15 economically important traits. Traits including fertility, feed efficiency, average daily gain, some of the important maternal traits like stayability. So those are some important traits that we're able to look at and evaluate in an animal early in its productive life to figure out which animals excel over others in that operation.
I think with today's economy, it's even more important that producers make the right decisions. The comprehensive Igenity profile allows them a look inside their animal that is not available anywhere else and allows them to make better financial decisions as well as better decisions towards their goals going forward than anything else that's available.
The Igenity profile, for me as a manager, has given me a valuable tool to use in our operation here to make decisions that affect our bottom line.
Cockrell worked with Igenity sales representative Sam Lewis to put the power of DNA to work on the Carter Ranch. That effort began with collecting DNA samples.
Through our Igenity tag, we have the ability to collect that information as simple as just putting in an ear tag. The convenience of our tag allows us to collect samples at several times. The most popular times to collect Igenity samples would be at bull soundness exams, branding possibly, at weaning, any time as early as possible in that animal's life that you want to try to make some kind of a selection.
When we went into this process using Igenity profile, I will have to admit I was a little anxious about the ease of using the tagging operation. You know, is this going to slow us down at shoot side? And gosh, it was so simple. It did not slow us down. If you can use the tagging pliers, you can use the Igenity tag.
Once the samples were collected and the Igenity profile came back, Cockrell had comprehensive DNA data that told him exactly where his individual animals stood in terms of 15 key economic traits.
The Igenity can look at that inside information in those animals early in its productive life. So from one single DNA sample, we'll be able to provide back to a producer 15 Igenity profile scores that we believe are very important for his operation.
Then producers can apply the information from the Igenity profile by using the Igenity software to sort the information based on their individual goals.
The Igenity software would be what I would refer to as being cowboy simple. The tagging process was very simple. You know, the computer process and the sorting on there was something that someone who is not a computer expert, you know, can certainly do with ease.
The information is only as good as what you do with it. And so you can profile an animal, you can get the parentage on an animal, and unless you take action on that information, it is useless. And so that's where my role comes in, is I spend time with that producer, working through that information, utilizing that information to help them reach their goals.
Let's go back to Texas, where reporter Brian Baxter is learning more about how cattlemen can put DNA profiles to work in their operations.
On the Carter Ranch, the Igenity profile is allowing Wayne Cockrell to have inside information on his animals soon enough to make decisions that impact herd quality and his bottom line.
The Igenity profile, you know, allows us to make those percentage choice decisions on a live cow that we have now. Not 2 years from now, when we get that carcass data back and then try to trace that back, you know, to the cow herd and to the bull, I've got that information right now. This is something that we were looking for. Since we're being paid a performance bonus on these cattle and we know what we're producing, we had made changes on the bull side, and really the area that we were trying to improve our genetics on was on the percentage of choice product. Our yield was great, you know, feed efficiency was okay. We'd done about all we could do on the bull side. So trying to improve our choice product without giving up reproduction and feed efficiency and all those things.
One of the tough decisions many commercial cow-calf operators face is deciding which heifers to keep as replacements. With his Igenity profiles in hand, Cockrell is able to make those choices with confidence.
The Igenity software allowed us to do a weighted sort on those results, and taking those results, we were able to eliminate the bottom 30% of those heifers. And I think that's key to remember as a commercial cow operator. Not that we're trying to just pick the super cows out of there. If I can eliminate the bottom 30%, those are the cows that cost us some money. And so the Igenity program allowed us to do that.
For him, the Igenity profile and software tools have delivered real value on the bull side too.
We also tested our bull herd. We weighted those bulls on a weighted sort. What are our top bulls? Where did those bulls originate from? What are those genetics? That's some powerful information that in turn allowed me to go to some bull sales where we had purchased bulls prior to that. You know, I went in there with a piece of information that a lot of other people didn't have.
Bottom line, the DNA data on individual animals provided by the Igenity profile is quickly becoming essential information many cattle producers aren't willing to do without.
Information, you know, the Igenity profile gives us information that we are able to use to make management decisions that may be the difference in allowing us to stay in the cattle business in the years to come.
Reporting from Texas, I'm Brian Baxter for NCBA's Cattleman to Cattleman.
To learn more about Igenity and how DNA technology can be applied on your cattle operation, visit our website at cattlemantocattleman.org or visit igenity.com. We'll be right back.
Comprehensive, practical, powerful. Now's the time to put the power of DNA to work in your herd with the comprehensive Igenity profile. The inside information from Igenity can help you make more confident replacement heifer and herd sire selection decisions, add marketability to your feeder cattle, make faster genetic progress, and more. The best time to get started is when you're already working cattle, during branding, weaning, or bull soundness exams. Get started today. Visit Igenity.com or call 1-877-IGENITY to put the power of DNA to work in your herd.
I'd like a moment with you cow-calf folks to talk about BQA, the Beef Quality Assurance Program. BQA has been designed to reduce bruises, blemishes, lamenesses, and impolite behavior in the calves you market. The point is to guarantee as best we can to our buyers and to consumers that we cattlemen know what we're doing, that we're treating our animals right, and the meat they buy is safe and wholesome. Now, most of the big feedlots and ranchers have signed on already, But that leaves the rest of us, and even if you only have 20 cows and a job in town, you need to be involved. Because every calf you sell is going to wind up on a plate someday, and we want our customers, all of them, to have a great dining experience, right? BQA helps furnish you with management tools and useful information to increase the value of your calves. So check it out at BQA.org and see what it takes to be involved in your state, because it's the right thing to do.
Discover a great roundup for beef producers. Now Boehringer Ingelheim Vetmedica Incorporated has rounded up the top brands of animal health products. You bet your boots you won't find more ways to protect your cattle. So trust the leader to protect your cattle. Trust Boehringer Ingelheim. Talk to your Boehringer Ingelheim Animal Health representative and discover how we can help your operation.
Quality matters to me because I'm responsible for managing the natural resources under my care, providing clean water and healthy feed, and creating an environment that fosters new life. I care for mother cows and newborn calves, nurturing them through the beginning of the life cycle. The entire beef industry is relying on me to provide a quality product they can work with. This is the beginning of the American beef industry. I'm proud of what we'll do here today.
Your stocker operation is a pack on the pounds enterprise, where your goal is to get the animals to the feed yard fast. Every minute counts as you battle the weather, livestock genetics, and health issues. Now, there's a powerful new dual-action therapy for your doctoring crew that shares your need for fast action. Resflor Gold. Ask your veterinarian about Resflor Gold. See improvement in as few as 6 hours with Resflor Gold.
Welcome back. Technology, it's affecting the way beef cattle producers do business. From ultrasounds to RFID tags, technology is now a growing part of many operations across the country. And now, thanks to broad television coverage, more and more people are now understanding another new technology, DNA. But as reporter Brian Baxter explains, DNA technology goes far beyond solving crimes, as beef producers are using it to find new solutions to their everyday production needs.
Cattle producers have seen the advent of several technologies such as EPDs and artificial insemination that have changed the way they do business. Now, with the help of Igenity, DNA technology is becoming an essential and easy-to-use tool producers are applying to their herds to take some of the risk out of the decisions they make every day, which is especially important when profit margins are tight.
Igenity is the most comprehensive product on the market right now in using DNA for selection. Producers take that profile and use it to choose which traits are specifically important to them, to their operation, and make selection decisions based on their management practices and on their goals.
Traits such as fertility and feed efficiency, average daily gain, and stability are key traits in terms of for the profitability of cow-calf producers. So with the Igenity profile, we can look at those traits as well as other traits that are economically important to producers and give them an opportunity to evaluate animals at an early age on which animals that are going to excel in terms of their overall genetic potential in their operation to make sure these cattle are going to hit the mark in terms of meeting their herd's objectives of what they're trying to produce.
Whether it's a seed stock operation, a commercial producer looking at their bull purchasing program or at heifer replacements, or even a feed yard, the Igenity profile puts inside information in the hands of producers early in the animal's life to help them make better selection and management decisions to ultimately improve efficiency and herd performance.
So we really look at it as a great complement to the existing genetic tools. The real advantage of Igenity profile is that we can find out the animals that excel in terms of their genetics, the inside information, if you will, in animals early in their life, when they're born, at weaning time, at branding. We can find that information out right away on those 15 economically important traits and give that information ahead of time to the producer so they can make some judgments.
The unique thing about our Igenity profile is that we have several traits that we can look at and use in an operation create the most comprehensive picture of what the DNA of that animal is that's available today. And with that information, we can take and pick out those traits that are specifically important to that operation to reach their goals. The main way that my producers are using the Igenity Profile as a selection tool, and then using our software as a way to sort animals and rank them from top to bottom to find a top end and a bottom end to make cull and keep decisions on heifers or bulls.
At Callion Farms in College Station, Texas, Byron Vassberg is a purebred Brahman producer who's quickly become a believer in the value of the Igenity Profile.
There has been a big change in the last 2 or 3 years in DNA technology. The availability of new markers, the way that we go about proving them, validating them. Now that Igenity has a large profile using a lot of markers, the accuracy for the traits we are looking at has increased. We're able to make and use them for selection, as a selection tool, and make improvement wherever we want. Where before you were looking at one trait, one marker, it had some influence, but not like today. So you're able to use it for bulls, for your cows, if you're into real high-end breeding, or if you're commercial. There's a lot of ways to use the technology.
Technology is becoming such an important part of our industry, and it now involves DNA profiles for cattle. Let's return to reporter Brian Baxter, who's discovering more in Texas.
Covering most of Texas, Igenity sales representative Sam Lewis is one of those who works closely with commercial and seed stock producers to review the information they receive from the Igenity Profile and help producers apply it to their individual herd goals to make better and more confident decisions.
The information is only as good as what you do with it. And so you can profile an animal, you can get the parentage on an animal, and unless you take action on that information, it is useless. And so that's where my role comes in, is I spend time with that producer, working through that information, utilizing that information to help them reach their goals.
Working with Sam Lewis to review the data in the Igenity Profile of his herd, Byron Vassberg is keenly interested in having objective tools that can help him make faster, more accurate decisions that will improve the performance of his purebred Brahmins.
The use of Igenity's Profile has allowed us to get rid of the animals that do not perform in whatever trait we're looking for. We get rid of them fast. You make very quick improvement. Because the technology was not there before, people were not able to select in any of those traits, okay, or make a quick selection to get rid of the bottom statistic performers. We are now able to do that with Igenity's Profile. Because I'm comfortable with the people that I'm working with, you get answers really quick. That's very important. We're going to make rapid change in this herd. We're going to make rapid changes in this industry by using the Igenity Profile.
While some might think the DNA information in the Igenity Profile would pay off most for a seed stock producer, Vassberg says the value to the commercial producer is also clear.
Feed efficiency markers right now to a cow-calf producer, large or small, does not matter. We're in a drought right now. As an example, here in Texas, we're buying feed. You just saw a feed truck go by. Simplest thing right there, the DNA markers, if selected for properly, used properly, you can make a 15 to 20% improvement in any breed, not my breed, any breed. That's 15 to 20% off your feed bill.
It works. It's comprehensive, it's powerful. Producers, I mean, especially in these times where it's challenging from an economic standpoint, they have to use all the information and all the technology that's available to them. Igenity Profile is one of those tools that allows them to get a little leg up on what they've been doing traditionally over the years.
Adding the Igenity Profile to their selection and management toolbox can help beef producers make better decisions, ultimately helping to avoid costly mistakes. From Southeast Texas, I'm Brian Baxter reporting for Cattleman to Cattleman.
Join the National Cattlemen's Beef Association. NCBA is the premier cattle industry organization representing your best interests in Washington, D.C. and across the country.
I want to have my voice heard, and this is the strongest way I can speak it, is through NCBA. And my little voice gets a lot of magnitude with this group.
Well, I've been an NCBA member for a long time. My family thoroughly believes in giving back to the industry that they make a living from, and you know, I've carried that on from generation to generation, and this is the organization of choice for the beef industry.
Every day, NCBA works to represent you on issues including trade, taxes, food safety and nutrition, animal welfare, and the environment.
The main reason I'm an NCBA member is to become engaged, more knowledgeable about everything that's going on in the beef industry.
It's easy to join NCBA. Just visit beefusa.org or call us at 1-866-USA-BEEF.
These days, more cattlemen choose Draxxin to fight BRD than any other brand. Here's why.
It works. We have fewer repulls. And the ones that we do repull respond, and we have fewer chronics in the end.
To retreat anything it's a lot more expensive than using Draxxin as the first time.
And the evidence backs up what most cattlemen already know. Draxxin cuts retreats by 50%. So talk to your veterinarian and check the online calculator at Draxxin.com. You'll see why Draxxin should be your first choice to fight BRD.
Basically, what it's allowed us to do with our operation is run more cattle through in a given period of time. It's just really been a good product to use.
Do not use in female dairy cattle 20 months of age or older. Do not use in calves to be processed for veal. Draxxin has a pre-slaughter withdrawal time of 18 days. Please visit Draxxin.com or call 1-888-DRAXXIN for more information.
You're not responsible for the weather, just the cattle. And Rangeland works as hard as you do to deliver performance, production, and profitability. Cattle need consistent nutrition. They'll get it year-round with Rangeland products from Land O'Lakes. Deliver what they need free choice in weather-resistant loose minerals and mineral and protein tubs. Get the most out of your forage. See your Land O'Lakes co-op for products that will stand up to whatever Mother Nature throws at us. Weather's coming in. Rangeland. Consider it done.
You like the John Deere 568 round baler for everything it has. Now, you'll like it even more for what it doesn't. Get rid of the twine tie system and run a 568 with nothing but net. That's right, nothing but easy loading, fast wrapping, bale protecting, cover edge net wrap. Put one to work in your field. See your John Deere dealer today.
Welcome back. Many cattle producers wish they had a crystal ball to predict the future. No doubt one of the things they would want to know is which animals in their herd will be most productive and profitable, and which ones will cost them money. Brian Baxter has more on a powerful tool ranchers can use to help them make more confident decisions.
Northwest Montana is home to Hughes Ranch, an Angus-based cow-calf operation running more than 2,500 cows. Steve Hughes and his family have been in the commercial cow-calf business for many years and often retain ownership of their calves in the feed yard. Now, Steve is using iGenity to help select replacement heifers to help improve the quality of his herd.
It doesn't make a difference if you run 25 cows, 50 cows, 100 cows, 2,000 cows. Each cow has got to be important to your operation. It's got to produce a good calf and some income for you on the net side, not the negative side. And the quickest way to do that, I think, is by this other tool that you can use in DNA testing. iGenity does that for us. We get good information back pretty fast, and we can utilize it fairly fast.
iGenity is a comprehensive and powerful genetic profile that looks at and provides analysis on 15 economically important traits. Some of those traits would be things like carcass quality, marbling, some important maternal traits, such as heifer pregnancy rate, stayability, calving ease.
Working with iGenity, Hughes says DNA technology has become an essential and easy to use tool.
I think it's a new exciting tool that a cow-calf operator can utilize to improve his herd and to get more dollars for his calves as he improves his herd and finds out that the calves he's producing and continues to produce are reaching a higher quality and he should be paid for it.
Igenity helps reduce the risk that comes along with beef cattle production. So Igenity helps them have more inside information, more tools and information in their fingertips to make more correct decisions ultimately.
DeHaan says producers in every segment from seed stock operations on through to the feed yard are working with Igenity to identify genetic potential for economically important traits like tenderness, feed efficiency, and stayability.
We can look at those traits and identify the animals that are superior in those traits early in an animal's stage of production. And so it allows producers to make those important decisions at weaning time or, you know, when they're looking at selecting replacement heifers. They can look at that inside information and do a better job in selecting animals that are going to fit their objectives of their operation.
The information Igenity provides can help producers make decisions in all phases of the operation. With his experience using the Igenity profile, Steve Hughes is now using the technology to help with all of his decisions, from retaining ownership to breeding to selecting replacement heifers.
I think it's given us and will give us an opportunity to improve our cow herd. You know, a lot of times you experiment and you try to figure things out and you waste some time and effort and money going the wrong direction. Where this way, you have the calf in the chute, you're going to have it there anyway, or the cow, you punch it out, or the bull, you send the information, that's all the work you do. And within 2 weeks or a month, you get the data back, and you can look at it and say, you know what, it's a good bull, or it's a good cow, or it's a good calf, based on that information. It's another tool that you can utilize.
Let's return to the Hughes Ranch in Montana to learn more about the powerful Igenity profile.
Collecting samples can be as simple as applying an ear tag thanks to the Igenity tissue collection device. In addition, producers can choose to use a combination RFID tag and tissue collection device, which makes DNA collection and electronic identification possible in one simple step.
Most times producers will collect the samples when they're already processing the cattle, whether that's at weaning or even branding, or perhaps sometimes when you're breeding soundness, evaluating a bull, or preg checking your heifers.
We use that deal that punches it out, and we find that quicker and faster. We run a pretty good bunch of cows and number-wise, and so the simpler we can do it, the quicker we can do it, the better it is for us and for the cattle.
In addition to our normal tissue collection tag, producers can also get a tag that's an RFID combination tag. That way they can take care of two processes in one step if they're involved in an agent source verification program.
In this day and age, if you've got a tool that you can utilize that'll get you the information much quicker, obviously that's the way I think you should go, and that's why we're doing what we're doing.
Igenity also provides software and one-on-one guidance to help producers turn this advanced information into actionable knowledge. Courtney Keeley is one of the many Igenity advisors that work closely with producers like Steve to review the information they receive from the Igenity profile and help make sure it's applied toward their individual goals.
After the producer has collected the tissue sample and gets the results back, we'll go over the data, and by identifying those goals and where they want to go, then we can set up a program for selection for traits and animals that meet the goals to get them where they'd like to go in the future.
Once the producer sends in his samples, we do the Igenity profile and we send that producer his results back. Then the most important part is going through the results, using some of our information resources and software programs to sort through all the results to ultimately allow them to make more confident decisions when it comes to either selection, management, or marketing of their calves.
For producers like Steve Hughes who are aiming to add value to their calves and even to retain ownership of those calves, the DNA data on individual animals provided by the Igenity profile is quickly becoming essential information they're not willing to do without.
We'll never reach 100% choice on our calves in the feedlot, obviously. It's just not going to happen. But we're going to be able to increase our percentage of choice cattle over time, hopefully, and get to a higher percentage so we'll get more money for our calves on the grid.
Once my customers have started using Igenity, they have found they cannot afford to make decisions without Igenity.
This is a very competitive market. All producers know that. It's one that we're working on very small and tight margins. It's really a market that's very unpredictable. So producers need to use everything at their fingertips, including DNA technology, to do the most they can in terms of improving the odds of making a profit year in and year out.
And the comprehensive identity profile can help make sure your herd is heading down the most profitable path. Reporting from Montana, I'm Brian Baxter for NCBA's Cattleman to Cattleman.
To learn more about identity and how DNA technology can be applied in your cattle operation, visit our website at cattlemantocattleman.org or identity.com. We'll be right back.
Comprehensive, practical, powerful. Now's the time to put the power of DNA to work in your herd with the Comprehensive Identity Profile. The inside information from Identity can help you make more confident replacement heifer and herd sire selection decisions, add marketability to your feeder cattle, make faster genetic progress, and more. The best time to get started is when you're already working cattle, during branding, weaning, or bull soundness exams. Get started today. Visit Identity.com or call 1-877-IDENTITY to put the power of DNA to work in your herd. Tough trailers built for tough country. Big Bend Trailers manufactures a different kind of trailer, one that's built to put up with the rough conditions found on the ranch. Rugged built using heavy-gauge powder-coated steel and a 2x4 rectangle tube frame. There's a 1-inch gap between the side and floor, so there's no place for water or manure to accumulate and rust. Big Bend trailers are loaded with standard features: a lever-action hitch, a 3-foot escape gate, and a middle sorting gate, rhino lining along the front edges, and a receiver hitch to tow another trailer, chute, or other equipment. Tough and practical. That's Big Bend trailers, designed and built by a working cattleman. You can rely on and trust Big Bend trailers for their durability and convenient features. Reasonably priced for any rancher to afford. For a list of dealers and other design features, visit BigBendTrailers.com. Big Bend Trailers, built cattleman tough.
Two 100% pure USDA inspected patties are only the beginning of what make the Big Mac famous. And that's what we're made of.
Profit, confidence, value. That's what you get with TriMerit, a USDA process verified program brought to your operation by Global Animal Management Incorporated. TriMerit's data management system certifies traditional health processes as well as verifies age and source of individual and groups of animals. To learn more about how TriMerit can play a positive role in your operation, visit mygamonline.com.
Quality matters to me because our local farmers and ranchers entrust us with the marketing of their livestock each and every week. It's their livelihood and how they provide for their families. Also, friends and families in the community eat at our cafe and watch the auction to be connected with the beef industry. I take great pride in knowing that my livestock auction keeps this community strong and provides our consumers with a great image of the beef they eat. I'm very proud of what we will do here today.
Welcome back. The 2010 NCBA Trade Show will have an amazing array of exhibitors. One of the exhibitors you'll see in San Antonio has a philosophy that life has enough headaches and your hat shouldn't be one of them. He's my friend Trent Johnson of Greeley Hat Works, and he's known the world over for his handmade cowboy hats. Cattleman to Cattleman headed to Greeley, Colorado recently to find out more about this 101-year-old business.
Hi, I'm Trent Johnson. Welcome to Greeley Hat Works. Let me tell you about my store.
Well, it started out as Greeley Hat and Shine Parlor in 1909 in downtown Greeley. And it was started by two Greek brothers. I'm actually the fourth hat maker to own it. And I was an apprentice here for 3.5 years before I bought it. First thing is definitely very much customer-based, is being able to talk to the customer about, you know, besides just color and style, but what's the function of the hat? How do they wear a hat? How are they going to use the hat? That only helps us determine kind of how to build it, not just for dimensions and shape, but also helps us give recommendations and suggestions on what quality of hat they should get and why. We have got to build hats for lots of famous folks, like I think the last 10 presidents of the NCBA, that was at the top, and then after that, you know, we got to do President Bush a few times. And then he hooked us up with some other people like Vladimir Putin and Secretary General of the United Nations, the Emir of Kuwait, Rudy Giuliani, lots of other people. Really, the importance of having something handcrafted, because, I mean, there are nice machine-made hats. I mean, a lot of the brand X type big box hat companies, they do have some nice products, but there's no ownership of that hat. I'm not running a factory here. My whole thing is about the ownership of the hat. So when an order comes in, whether it's an individual or a store, one of my guys or gals gets that order from start to finish, except for the parts, you know, like Sharon prints all the sweatbands and sews them together. But as far as building the hats, everybody gets and puts their initials in it. So if the customer's really happy, we know who built the hat. And if there is an issue, there's no passing the buck. It isn't like, oh yeah, processor number 14 forgot to do that part of the step. And we all take great ownership in being able to build good products. So one of the fun things about either, you know, coming into our store here in Greeley, visiting one of our retail partners, or finding us at a show on the road, is being able to help create your hat. You know, so in our store and a lot of our trade show displays, we have a lot of hats like these that are open and flat that haven't been shaped. And these are just waiting for owners to give them the character that they need. I mean, creases in hats are very personal. It's kind of an extension of your personality. So on this one, this is a nice light tan hat called this is called Sahara. This is a binding and a 12-line ribbon. This gives it a little bit of an Old West flair, but it's still a very functional hat. And then when you go in a little bit more contemporary, a lot of the newer hats have more of a shoveled or squared crease across here. Once again, now we've still got a ribbon band on here, but this is a kind of a spin-off of the open road type ribbon without the tails, something we hear, we call it a J-bow. But once again, the binding on most hats doesn't really serve a function as much as of a type of style. Now this is one of my most favorite colors. This is natural beaver. There's no bleach or dye. It's a very nice neutral color. It's the same color as dirt, and it'll go with anything your wife makes you wear. So this one is always a safe bet. Our buckle sets on all of our beaver blends and pure beavers are sterling silver, hand engraved, made here in the US by Americans. I know it's a novel concept, but it still does happen. And then, as we were talking earlier about some of the upgrades, this is a finger carved sweatband. So it's all hand carved. We could put your name in there, we could put a brand or something. And once again, it really doesn't serve a function, but it looks really nice and would definitely make any owner proud. Same quality as all of our other hats. The PBR line has a PBR buckle, PBR markings on the inside on the sweatband and the liner. But once again, could be customized in 9 different colors and about any type of style. So a lot of what we see around the US, especially with national cattlemen's and more beef producers and farmers and ranchers, is more of a cattleman style. Once again, it's probably not out of function anymore as much as it used to be, but I mean, this is what Dad wore, this is what Grandpa wore, so it's gonna kinda be your own type of family tradition. But we put lots of different spins on it and can make any kind of hat you'd like.
It's a part of a cowboy's wardrobe that has both function and a rich heritage, the cowboy hat. We recently had a chance to learn more about both the function and the fashion of today's cowboy hats from our friends up at Greeley Hat Works.
I think the reason the cowboy hat has endured is, you know, I guess really it's a symbol of the American West and of freedom. And, you know, you could watch liberal media and hear how much everybody hates America. I sell a ton of cowboy hats in England, Switzerland, Germany, France, Australia, all these different places. that they might not like our policies in the U.S., but they love cowboys, they love American West. So we started out in the front, the showroom of the store, but I'd like to show you around the back here. So once we get the order in, we start by cutting the sweatband. And that's where we do this over here. And we use several different colors of sweatbands. It kind of depends on the customer or the order. But we print them, we can print your name on them. Some of the equipment we use is made so we can cut them specific sizes. Otherwise, we'll cut the sweatband right to your head pattern. So all of our hats are all kind of one size fits no one. They come in different colors and different qualities. And once we do that, we'll bring them over here and we'll get ready to start blocking the hats. Now what the blocking does is pushes a block into the crown of the hat so that we could steam it. The steam actually helps lock the fibers together, so that makes what makes a good hat tight and stiff. Okay, so what we do over here, once we pick out the appropriate hat body, and we've had your head measured or we know what size hat you wear, depending on the style, we'll pick out the appropriate hat block for your hat. Once we do that, we'll get ready to put it in this machine here. This is called a finger blocker. And what this is gonna do is push the block of the hat into the crown of the hat body, like this. So once we do that, we'll let it cool in here for 5 to 10 minutes. And once it's cooled and it comes out, you'll now see that the crown of the hat is into the hat body. Like this. So now we have a definite break line from the crown and the brim of the hat. We'll tie this onto the hat block, and once it's cool is when we'll start the sanding process. So what we've done here is we've already blocked the hat, pressed the brim flat, and we've already sanded the crown of this hat. All the nap is going down in one direction, and all the felt has been sanded down, ironed and lured or re-greased, because it's like hair. You have to put good oil back into it since we've kind of dried it out with our process. And now what we've done is cut the brim, and we're starting to work on the brim here. And that's what Jacob here is doing, is hand sanding the brim of the hat. Once we take it out of the blocker, we need to press that brim flat. And that's what we do here with these sandbag presses. We'll put the hat into a flange, and this helps differentiate the crown from the brim and makes a break line where later we will actually sew the sweatband into the hat. So now that we've blocked and flanged the hat, sanded it, trimmed the brim, we're ready to sew the sweatband in. So the first thing we do is test the sweatband in the hat, make sure everything's fitting up nice. Now the sewing machine we're gonna be using is an old Singer. This was built in the late 20s. And you'll see it has a really, really long neck on it, and that's to allow this to go for the brim to fit into the machine. And now the sweatband is sewn into the hat. After this, we'll take it over to Sharon, where the excess that we cut off of the brim, we actually turn into a self band made out of felt with a buckle on it, and that's normally how we trim the hats. But as always, it's a custom hat. We'll do it however you like. So here's a custom hat that we've just finished up. Got the self band with a silver buckle. The brim's been cut to 4 inches. The sweatband's been sewn in. And we've actually made a cedar pattern of his head. It's all been lined, natural leather sweatband. His name's been put in the hat. So now what we're gonna do is go ahead and crease it to his specifications from when we measured him at the show. And once again, the steam is softening up those fibers or the scales on the hair. And then as it cools off, they'll interact with each other and kind of grab onto each other and get stiff again. And that's what makes a good hat. So really, not a whole lot has changed over the course of 100 years. Still done by hand and still loving what we do. So there we go. Fit right to the exact shape of his head, creased up and ready to be shipped out.
It's amazing to see those hats being made, and even more amazing to wear one. For more information on Greeley Hat Works, visit our website at cattlemantocattlemen.org. Stay with us. Baxter Black is up next.
Get ready for the Rocky Mountain Roundup. Join the 2011 Cattle Industry Annual Convention and NCBA Trade Show in the city that gets 300 days of sun a year, Denver, Colorado. It's not only a great opportunity to connect with your fellow cattlemen, but you will also attend important industry meetings, find out about the newest technologies, and get all the information you need for a successful year. We'll see you in Denver at the Cattle Industry Annual Convention and NCBA Trade Show, February 2nd through the 5th. For more information, visit beefusa.org.
You take pride in the beef you raise. Countless hours invested to assure a safe and wholesome calf crop. Why trust that calf crop to just anyone? Experience the new Dinklage difference. With a long history and reputation for outstanding performance and cattle care, we use a combination of cutting-edge technologies and data-driven decision-making to establish our place as leaders in the cattle feeding industry. Allow Dinklage to be a part of your team in the quest to maximize your profits, with 5 locations to serve you in Wyoming, Nebraska, and Colorado. For more information on the new Dinklage difference, stop by one of our yards or visit us on the web at dinklagefeedyards.com.
Before you head out here, get ready at Cabela's, your source for the hottest new gear at tough-to-beat prices. Save big on everything you need when you shop by catalog, stores, and online at Cabela's.com. Our legendary selection is field-tested and field-proven. You can trust our gear. Cabela's, world's foremost outfitter.
Our quarter pounder with cheese is made from 100% pure USDA beef. That means there's 0% anything else. That's what we're made of.
Trust. Out here, it's that rare combination of reliability, integrity, and the peace of mind that comes with having both. After 20 years of making hitches, the B&W Turnover Ball has become the most trusted gooseneck hitch in the country. Why is that important? Because trust is not only hard to earn, it's hard to find. The Turnover Ball Gooseneck Hitch by B&W. Trusted.
Beef Quality Assurance, BQA, is a program designed to ensure the consumer that your beef is safe and wholesome and of the highest quality, and it lets the buyers of your calves know that you know what you're doing. It's consumer friendly and can be a big part of giving them a great dining experience. So check it out at BQA.org and see what it takes to get involved in your state. Whether you got 15 cows or 1,500, it's the right thing to do.
How many of y'all have ever caught a rope under a horse's tail? You'd think an animal in the top 10 of intelligence would raise his tail and let it fall out, but they don't do that. As a matter of fact, they do just the opposite. There are strange tales told in the days of old when cowboys tested their luck. But the queerest portrayal of life on the trail was when Dunny ran off with the duck. The boys and I were driving steers up north and stopped at Hymer to rest the bunch and have some lunch and just restoke our primer. We tied our horses to the fence, commenced to telling whoppers, and thus inclined, we watched a line of ducks come hunting hoppers. Well, those ducks fell in behind our steeds and sorted through their droppings for bits of grass or oats they'd pass like barnyard fowl out shopping. Well, young Orville hefted up a duck, which kind of starts this caper. Behind unfazed, old Dunny raised his tail to break a vapor. Why people do the things they do remains a constant wonder. Like Orville there, saw tail midair and stuck the duck up under. To say it took his breath away would sure describe old Dunny. And just as true, I reckon too, that duck was breathing funny, because underneath old Dunny's tail, two wings protruded oddly and filled the air with flying hair. The racket was ungodly. You talk about a hissy fit. Both fur and fowl got ruffled. Above the din, the duck chimed in, although his quack was muffled. Well, old Dunny reared and broke his reins. The other horses bolted and ran askew while feathers flew like Pegasus had molted. I saw him top a distant hill, headed home in earnest. Like somewhere back, he'd been attacked by a drunken taxidermist. Well, young Orville took his chewing square, but we finally all deduced by Josephine we'd never seen one duck instead of ghost. But what about the duck, you ask? Well, he didn't stay for dinner, so I don't doubt he stuck it out, or in, and rode on south for winter. This is Baxter Black from out there.
Welcome back. Let's take a look at this week's legacy photos. We love seeing your photos, so keep sending them in. If you have a photo you'd like to submit, you can do so by visiting our website at cattlemantocattlemen.org. Thanks so much for joining us on this week's edition of NCBA's Cattleman to Cattleman. We'll see you right back here next week on RFD TV.